Hey, Eddie Fish. It's the 26th of February 2018. Man, time flies. But I see this morning, you know, I knew this was coming up, and man, every time I see this, all I think is, here they go again, re-fertilizing all those seeds of fear and hatred and everything that all these incidents brought about. And the fact that this 1993 bombing was 100% known by the FBI and other entities and was allowed to go forward. I mean, it's just that simple. People want to look into this stuff, they will, but most don't. And they will become the sheep led to slaughter. It's that simple. Because that's all this is just Satan's spirit reminding you that he rules, that fear, that doubt, that insecurity, okay? We need safety and security, and you are never going to get it through these men. I'm sorry. It doesn't matter who it is. Men are men. You need God. You need Jesus. It's just that simple, okay? So this is what they're doing today. And I want to just give you a couple examples of how this spirit works and manifests itself through men, most of them not even knowingly, not at all. They're just doing a job, right? But this is how it works, because the world has succumbed to the sin of the world. It's the flesh, okay? And it's temporary. Don't forget, your flesh is very temporary, okay? So a couple of quick little, you know, examples of how these things are just this veneer of evil that have flown along with the river of time since the very beginning. And it shows through their little rituals and when they do these events and when these occur. When I say they, I mean Satan. It's the spirit of Satan that fuels men because they are pursuing the things of the flesh. They want money. They want power. They want sex. They want this. And they go about it by any means necessary. And it counts even in the littlest of things. A little lie, a little, you know, stealing a little thing. Doesn't matter. You can't be a little pregnant, right? So don't lie, because that feeds the beast. But, you know, at this point, the beast is just here. I mean, it's here. We are in the end days. It's just that simple. You need only look around. But if you're not in Christ, you're not going to know that. So the whole point is, you know, get right with God, right? But between this incident here in 93 and the actual 2001 Trade Center bombings, right, was 3,119 days, 3,119, okay? And obviously what we can do with that. And then between 93 and today happens to be 9,131 days, okay? Now, you can call it a coincidence, you can call it whatever you want, but this is just a part of how that spirit moves through time and just leaves its mark, just like all of its vain shows on Earth, like things like the World Trade Center, right? What is the World Trade Center? It's nothing more than a vain show. That's all it is. Its ritual was performed there, its job was completed, and they erect their monuments to it, to literally mock the world and proclaim their domination, okay? I hope this is making sense, because if you're not in the Holy Spirit, okay, in other words, saved, you're not going to understand this stuff, and you're going to remain in fear. You're going to remain, and you're going to put your trust in men to give you safety and security. And if you look at anything historically, whether it be recent history or ancient history, men cannot bring you peace and safety. They can't, because this world has been tainted, has been leavened by this evil. Satan has free reign around this world, and he gets you through temptation and your lack of knowledge of God. If you don't know God, then you're just free game. You're just like this wild pig running around out in the brush, ready for the plucking. You know what I mean? It's that simple. You're an innocent sheep just being devoured. Okay? It really is that simple. These things aren't a coincidence, right? And one other thing I wanted to show you real quick. Remember last week, it was I was showing you about MIT. Oh, let's look at this. You remember the actual World Trade Center, right? Well, the first thing that they insisted they did was clear out that rubble, get it out of here as fast as we can. Orders of the president. Truck it out, throw it in the ocean, melt it down, get rid of all the evidence as fast as possible. Why? Because it's too emotionally distressing to have that sit there so that we can thoroughly investigate this incident here. And as soon as they get a space cleared out in there, what do? They construct a circle and they bring in their dignitaries, your politicians, your elites. And what do? They form the Eye of Osiris, of Ra, of whatever. It's Satan, people. That's what it is. They are praising their master, showing their allegiance. And most of them don't even know that they are just marching into eternal hell fire. They really don't. Most people in this world have no clue, because they run people and steer them literally through their emotions. I mean, take this Florida shooting here, for example. I mean, how are they? They're literally kicking people off of Facebook and YouTube for asking questions and pointing out blatant, obvious, anomalies, and literally being persecuted for trying to tell the truth. Why? Because you're in the end days. That's all there is to it. You know, bad is good, good is bad. It's on its ear. It's turned upside down. Trump isn't going to save you. Netanyahu isn't going to save you. The only one that's going to save you is Jesus Christ. Okay? And it's really that simple. And I'm only telling this to those of you who don't know him. And showing you these things should I say, if you are in fact seeking the truth, should compel you to want to know more. And you will know everything that you need to know, and you will live in peace. Howbeit a bittersweet thing often to live in this world when you're in Christ, but the joy is immeasurable, and you know your salvation is secure. So the flesh is temporary. You can't forget that, you know. And I just wanted to real quick, remember last week I was showing you MIT, their number 7 entrance at 77 Massachusetts Avenue, the compass and squares, and the oculus. I would just wanted to point out real quick, you know, an oculus is just from the Latin. It means eye. That's it. A circular opening in the center of a dome. So just to show you how Satan loves to just be so vain and right in front of you. Why would they call this monstrosity the oculus? Because it's the eye of the serpent, right in your face, right in everybody's face. That's what it is. And what's the first thing that they did in this oculus, sitting here next to their giant memorial? What's the first thing they did in there? They put on a show of Michelangelo's Sistine Chapel. What is the Sistine Chapel? Well, that's where they vote in the Pope with their little black smoke and their white smoke and everything. The Sistine Chapel. This place. And what's in the Sistine Chapel? The beast. That's the beast, folks. That's the serpent. Okay? First thing they show in their oculus. So, if this doesn't get your curiosity going and you don't know Christ, I'm going to keep trying. But think about this stuff, will you? And how this spirit is all-encompassing unless you are saved by the blood of Christ. look into it, okay? With a humble heart. It'll do you good, trust me. I wanted to share that with you guys, though, and y'all have a great day. Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,